If you want to make sales, it's important that you're connecting with your community, right? For online businesses, one of the best ways to make real connections with people is through video. It's the best way to simulate in-person interactions, but online. Not only will video help you to establish a relationship with potential customers, but it's also a great marketing tool. Still, not all business owners are charismatic extroverts who shine in front of the camera. For introverts, the idea of putting yourself out there for the world to see might feel incredibly daunting, right? So today, I'm going to dive into some strategies that can help introverts get more comfortable in front of the camera. Hi, my name is Mei Park. I help artists, designers, and makers make a living selling their handmade products online. Plus, I run this YouTube channel, so I know firsthand how to use video to promote and grow your business. And if you've watched any of my older videos, you will see that I am not a natural when it comes to video, okay? I'm an extroverted introvert in the sense that while I love being with people in small group settings, I'm not usually the person who's talking and I overthink what I say all the time. And I was born and raised in Malaysia where we had accents and we didn't speak American English. It's a whole thing and I had a lot of reasons to be afraid of video. But it's something I've learned how to do, so I want to share that with you. Video is a great way to build customer trust and loyalty and help set us apart from our competition. And think about it. YouTube has over 2 billion active users, and Facebook and Instagram is always pushing its users to make more video content, which gets more views and engagement. Video can be a fantastic way to market our businesses in an intimate and personal way to a large number of viewers when done right. First and foremost, I just want to put the rumors to rest. Not every successful business needs to be doing video, okay? I want you to release yourself from the idea that you have to be doing video to make a living online. Yes, there are perks to doing video, and I know that people say that videos are where it's at right now, but the reality is that it's not necessary for most businesses. Making videos is super time consuming and not necessarily the best ROI depending on how you're doing it. So if it really, really isn't for you, don't sweat it. I don't want you to force it. There are plenty of other ways to build those connections with customers, like with email marketing, for example. Now, if you are ready to take the leap into the world of video for business, then these tips are for you. Before we start with the tips, though, the biggest thing I'll share, which sounds like a no-brainer, but is a really huge part of how to do better with video, is practice. You know, eventually, you will build up that comfort level, and hopefully, once it becomes easy for you, you get excited to make your videos. Okay, so my first tip to make video easier for you is to pretend you're talking to a friend instead of the internet or even to the camera. I mean, talking to an entire internet worth of strangers is intimidating, right? And it's not going to feel natural either. Same with talking to a camera. We're humans, not robots, and this type of talking is just not natural to us. It's really easy to get deep into your head when you're trying to address the entire internet, which could make you lose your train of thought or sound monotonous or make you super nervous. So instead of trying to address lots of people at once, imagine that you're just talking to a friend. Picture the person you trust most in the world and just start talking as if you're out to coffee together. This can help calm your nerves and keep your tone natural, focused, and even excited. I mean, who doesn't love sharing stories with their friends, right? You'll feel more comfortable and familiar, and that will come through in your speech. If you want to, you can even invite a friend over to stand near the camera lens while you're talking. Or, you know, if that's too much trouble, take a picture of them, print it out, and tape it near the camera lens, and that might be able to help take the edge off as well. Tip number two is to carefully plan your videos so there are no surprises. The better prepared you are for your videos, the better they will be. Duh, I know, right? But seriously, this is just a fact of life that sometimes I wish weren't true. Planning isn't the most fun thing to do, but many of the most popular YouTubers out there go all out with a pre-written script and even rehearsals so that they know that they're going to stay on topic and they'll make very few mistakes, if any, and have more confidence in what they're saying. As a result, their videos are high quality, they're professional, and they rake in those views, right? There are also a lot of people who create videos without a plan, and they tend to end up stammering through tangents without ever really nailing down the point of the video, often because they don't even know the point of the videos themselves. Those videos get a lot less views and a lot more thumbs downs. The better you plan ahead, the better you'll feel, and the better the video will be. So start with a clear idea of what your video will be about. What is the goal of the video? What do you want your viewers to leave with? And after you have a really solid idea, list out your main talking points in an outline. Think about what B-roll you might need to shoot. Then decide how you want to promote the video. Because remember, video is content marketing and you have to promote your video after you publish it or no one will see it. It might start to feel overwhelming, but trust me, that's totally normal. It's part of the process. Every one of my YouTube videos easily takes 10 or so hours of manpower to produce. So if you're working hard, you're doing something right. Totally normal. My third tip is to use a teleprompter so you don't lose track of your words and you stay on track. After all, what is the point of a script if you can't remember it? Now, there are plenty of teleprompter apps and softwares to choose from that allow you to read along with your script as you're talking to the camera. This is an amazing tool because you won't have to memorize everything, and you also don't need to try to read from a piece of paper or from your phone, so you can actually look at the camera the whole time you're speaking. Teleprompter in the App Store is a free, highly rated app that you can use. In addition to software or an app, you also need the teleprompter hardware. Your options really depend on what you're using to shoot your video to begin with though, but I've personally used the Parrot teleprompter kit for my Canon Rebel camera, and I can recommend that. Tip number four is to figure out a way to keep yourself accountable. People who get the most out of video, whether that's a YouTube channel or maybe doing Facebook Lives or Instagram Reels or Stories, they post content regularly. So find out what that means to you. It can be once a week, once a month. You just make sure you're consistent with that frequency. Make a video content calendar to keep you on schedule. There are habit and streak tracker apps like Habitica, I don't know if I'm saying that right, Habitica, that incentivize you to keep going or stay on task, right? Or if you're not much of an app person, you can have an accountability buddy. That's someone who's a friend who knows your deadlines and will hold you accountable to meeting those deadlines. You can also use a reward system for positive reinforcement, like give yourself a treat, like a trip to the ice cream shop for every goal you achieve. This is what I do. Every time I finish recording a batch of videos, I always feel so productive and I treat myself to a nice dinner. Or you can also hold yourself accountable by promising to donate money to a charity that you don't support if you fail to post your video. That should help keep you posting pretty consistently. Once creating videos and posting them becomes a habit for you, it will be so much easier to keep doing them, okay? I promise. Tip number five is to try not to stress about the length of the video. These videos don't need to be packed with a ton of information, okay? Keep it easy for yourself to post regularly by making your videos simple, fun, easy to understand. Viewers aren't looking for the most detailed information in the world anyway. They just want something clear, knowledgeable, and entertaining. Short videos can be just as, if not more effective, as long as you're clear about the goals for each video and how you want that video to serve your audience. So stay on point, keep it simple, and don't overload the information. My final tip is a fun one. Join an improv class. If you're not an actor, you might know about improv classes from shows like The Office, where Michael Scott takes improv classes after work for a few seasons. Improv is a form of theater where the scene, characters, and dialogue are all formed in the moment. In an improv class, you basically play games with your classmates in which you enact a story that you make up as you go along. So you really have to think on your feet. Now, I know what you're thinking. How is an acting class supposed to help me as a business owner? But let me tell you, these classes are not just about performing on stage or being the funniest person in the room. They're actually a fantastic, fabulous way to increase your confidence, learn key public speaking skills, and get used to thinking on your toes. And most importantly, get out of your own head. In fact, improv classes like Second City actually offer classes specifically for introverts and business owners. They help to train a part of your body and mind that just doesn't get a lot of use these days. And if you're like me, you might get stuck in your own head too much or second guess every word that comes out of your mouth or every decision for me as a business owner. Most of the time, I don't even trust myself to say cohesive sentences. Have you ever watched any of my YouTube video bloopers? It's like gibberish sometimes. There's just so much anxiety when it comes to speaking, especially to strangers or, you know, the whole internet. And where I grew up in Malaysia, our sentence structure is flipped a lot of times, like in Chinese language. So that's how my head thinks, and it comes out sounding like broken English. So improv has helped me so much. It was such a life changer. It's taught me how to get out of my head and be more comfortable with who I am, even celebrating the weird and goofy parts of me that I might have been self-conscious about before. My first improv class was a life-changing experience for me, and I recommend it to anyone who wants to do more video, or if you're just looking for a fun thing to do, or just for self-improvement. Making videos in your business is a lot of work, especially if you're an introvert. But with the right preparation, anyone can make videos work for their business. What are some of your tricks for speaking on camera? Let me know in the comment section. And if you like this video, you found it helpful, go ahead and subscribe to my channel and click that like button. Stay tuned for this next video to start for more handmade business tips.